I want to share with you from Gospel of Mark, chapter 1. It says in verse 34, "Then he healed many who were sick with various diseases and cast out many demons, but did not allow demons to speak because they knew him." And that verse sometimes is used to, I sometimes hear that verse being used against me. You know, why do we allow demons to speak during deliverance? Because look, Jesus did not allow demons to speak. But I want you to notice that in this verse it says, because they knew him. He didn't let him speak because he was already known by them. He did not want demons to make Jesus known to people. And not only he didn't want demons to make Jesus known, a little bit later you will see that it says, when he heals a leper, he says, "See that you say nothing." So he didn't want a leper to let people know that Jesus was, you know, the healer, the Messiah, and all of that good stuff. And then if you read a little bit later, you see that Jesus didn't even let a blind man know that he didn't let blind man to get the word out when he healed him that Jesus was the Son of God. We see when he revealed himself to Peter, he told him as well, he says, "Make sure you don't tell anybody that I am the Son of God," and guys, keep this hidden. And so I think, I'm not sure the real reason when we go to heaven, I'm going to ask Jesus, but I just want to share a thought with you that ministered to me today, and that is the fact that Jesus was known where it mattered. He was known in the superior realm. He was known in the spiritual realm. And he tried to stay unknown in the physical realm. And he was totally comfortable with people not knowing that God is among them. He was totally comfortable being anonymous, being hidden, not being popular, not being famous, not being viral, not being all of those things that I feel like in the modern world people aspire to have, partially because we see the advancement of technology and we also see how the plane has shifted. Whereas before, a lot of people wanted to be teachers, firefighters, police officers, and now a lot of kids, you know, they desire to be a YouTuber, an influencer, be famous, be somebody who can hit the ball really good, be a good actor, because those things, you know, give you perks and they give you finances and they give you connections. And that in itself is not bad. But the problem is when you desire it, when you pursue it, to be known when you are not known there, when you're not known in God's eyes, when you're not known in the realm of the Spirit, when you're not known in the spiritual world, but you're only seeking, when I'm only seeking to be known in the physical world, and we push ourselves so that we can be known, so that we can be discovered, so that we can be, and of course, a lot of times we say things like, "Well, I'm doing it for the kingdom. I'm doing it so I can spread the kingdom." Well, I don't think there was nobody in the world who wanted to spread the kingdom more than Jesus. Yet, I see in Jesus that he was hidden. He was unknown. And in fact, he wanted to stay like that. And so I just want to share a few thoughts with you that minister to me. As I've been praying on this, and I kind of read it and, you know, I saw a defense concerning deliverance, you know, that it's okay to let demons speak when it's needed. And this scripture is being taken out of the context. And so, and I moved on and I really felt to go back and I started to meditate and pray for myself. Where does this apply to me? And I draw these few simple conclusions for myself. One of them is to stay known where it matters. So to stay known where it matters. Where it matters is in the realm of the Spirit. Where it matters is to be known by God, to be known by the Holy Spirit. Honestly, to be known by demons is more important than being known by celebrities. Because when the spiritual realm knows you, that is more important than a TV host, a newspaper, a famous preacher, or some kind of a star. When you're known in the place that matters, that is what really matters. And so the question I would ask you today, as I'm asking myself, is, am I known by God? Am I known by demons? Or am I just driven, hungry, to be known by famous people on earth? Number two is, instead of focusing on somebody knowing us, we should turn our focus and make sure that we know someone that's important. And that someone, my friend, is the Holy Spirit. When who knows you, who you know makes very little difference. Who you know makes very little difference when it comes to people. But if you know the Holy Spirit, my friend, that is the most important thing. Look at Jesus. Jesus wasn't physically known by a lot of these religious people and everything. But have you noticed that Jesus had a hard time keeping himself unknown in this realm because he was known in that one? He had to ask people, please don't tell anybody about me. He had to rebuke demons, shut up and don't tell anybody about me. He had to tell his disciples, please don't tell anybody. So Jesus had to work hard on staying unknown because he was already known there. If you know Holy Spirit and the Holy Spirit knows you, my friend, I'm going to tell you one thing. This physical realm is going to know you. But even if it doesn't, it's not going to bother you. Because you will live with peace. Like Apostle Paul, he says, I count all things as rubbish that I may know him. Paul had a lot of accomplishments, a lot of gifts and talents and natural wisdom. But Paul says, all of that doesn't matter to me because what I want is to know him. I want to be known by him. And of course, as a result of that, in this physical world, in this realm, it's very difficult not to be discovered. It's very difficult not to be found when you're found there. And so I would just propose these two questions to you today as I'm asking myself is this one. Am I known there? Or if I'm just wanting to be known here? And number two, who do I know? Do I know God? Do I seek to know him? Or am I driven, passionate, so that I can know somebody who can maybe open some doors? And the last thing is, when I am known there, I will be totally comfortable not being known here. Why? Not every exposure, not every fame, not every notoriety is healthy. Jesus somehow, now I don't know, this is my speculation. I would love to hear your opinion on it, but my speculation is this, is that Jesus did not come on earth to reign as a king. He came to die as a lamb. He also came to build disciples. So it was against his calling. Now you may say, well, he should have, you know, let everybody know who he was and everything. That wasn't his calling. He's gonna come back. He's now spreading his fame through the church. But when he was here, it would actually restrict his calling to be famous. And this is a crazy thought to allow that sometimes being known will actually hurt your calling and your character when it's not what God assigned you for. Not every person needs exposure, visibility, spotlight to fulfill their calling. Some of us, it will actually hinder our calling. It will hinder and it will hurt our health, our mental health, our peace, our family when we pursue that which is actually we don't need. Jesus had enough knowledge, fame, visibility. He actually had more than he needed. And therefore, he had to ask people to slow it down. Please don't tell anybody. Please, why? Because I don't need it to fulfill my calling. And the more I get of that, the harder it will be for me to die. Remember how one time the king wanted to make him a king? And the Bible says he escaped. If this would have been a time of media, it would have been very difficult for Jesus to do what he did, which is to die on the cross. You know why? Because he would have been extremely famous. And a lot of people would not allow that. And so I think that, this is just my speculation. I'm not saying I'm right on that. Take it with a grain of salt. But the truth remains is that Jesus wanted to remain unknown. And I think that we need to find comfort in that, especially those of us in ministry, especially in the area today where everyone pursues the viral. Everybody pursues to be popular, to be famous, and people are really, you know, even if we mask it under, I just want to spread the kingdom and everything, a lot of times there are hidden agendas that are there that only Holy Spirit can help us to expose. And I am not in any way, shape, and form I'm going to point fingers on other people, because I need to point that finger first at myself. And it's first a conviction to me that, Lord, I want to be known by you. Lord, I want to know you. And Lord, I want to stay comfortable in the places where I'm unknown. And God, I also want to know how I can fulfill my calling, and you will give me enough of exposure that I need to fulfill my assignment. And if you don't give it to me, that means I don't need it. I just need to focus on my assignment, focus on my purpose, and focus on my calling. Not focus on being known, recognized, welcomed, honored, popular, famous, or all of that stuff. So this is my little encouragement for you today from what I've read and what ministered to me. I pray that it will minister to you. Holy Spirit, I just pray right now that you will help every person that is watching or listening or re-watching this, that they will have a desire to know you, that they will have a desire to be known by you, that they will not be discouraged, God, if somebody didn't give them a spotlight, recognition, fame, if there seemed to have a great anointing and calling, but nobody seems to take a highlight of that. Lord God, help us to redirect our focus, our energy, to be known by you, to know you, God, and to stay unknown if that is your will and if that is what our calling, our character demands for. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. God bless you guys. Wanted to remind you that Vlad School, if you haven't heard, it's available. There's a first course already there. More courses are coming very soon. All of my ebooks are available online. You can go and download it, and it's a free of charge. May God bless you for that. And for those of you that the Lord, if the Lord moves on your heart to be a supporter of the ministry of Vladimir Savchuk, you can go to the links in the description or to VladimirSavchuk.com. It would be much appreciated as we're taking the gospel to honestly many, many places through the means of media. God bless you and have a wonderful day.